Recall that using the default shard key, ROWID, randomly distributes the rows of a table across the shards. ROWID offers the best guarantee of an even distribution of data and processing, and it allows the most efficient parallel ingestion scenarios. But when a table is frequently joined to other tables, for example on the patient ID field, using the default shard key can be bad for performance because the joins must be executed across all the shards. You can avoid this problem by using co-sharded joins. As you learned in Lesson 1.1, in a co-sharded join, the joined rows are all located on the same shard. If you shard on patient ID, for example, all rows with the same patient ID value go to the same shard. This means the join can be executed locally and much more quickly. Let's look deeper into the patient ID example. If several tables in a healthcare database are frequently joined on the patient ID field, you would use that field as the shard key for all of them. All rows from the tables with the same value for patient ID would then be stored on the same shard, enabling co-sharded joins. Remember to evaluate all frequent joins before making a decision. By enabling one co-sharded join, you may be excluding another. For example, a table that does not contain the patient ID field cannot be co-sharded with any of those that were sharded on patient ID. And complex joins need careful attention to find the best sharding approach. You'll also have to evaluate unique constraints. When a sharded table has a unique constraint, such as a patient MRN, uniqueness must be enforced across all shards, substantially slowing the insert-update performance. When the shard key is a subset of the fields of the unique key, however, that uniqueness only needs to be enforced locally, on the shard where a row is inserted or updated, avoiding any performance impact. Because of this benefit, where insert-update performance is important, use one or more fields of the unique key as the shard key when sharding tables with a unique constraint or remove the constraint. You might choose to keep the unique constraint and accept the impact it will have on your application. As you consider this, you'll want to weigh the advantages of the default shard key and co-sharded joins, along with the tough unique constraints that may be present in your application, to determine what will be the best solution for you.